Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. So my mise en place is a little bit messy today because what you're about to see was not in the plan for today. Today out here in the studio in the kitchen, I was only going to do this recipe for the old cookbook show. And I was going to cook inside dinner for Julie and I. And I was going to make the chicken and grits recipe from, maybe 3 months ago. Because I really like that. I'm just going to make it. Get to the grocery store. Cart's already full. I go over to the meat counter. And there was no chicken. There was a sign apologizing that, you know, they had some sort of problem. There was no chicken. So what am I going to do? I had this plan in my head. So I pivot. Because strangely, this 450 grams or a pound of ground beef from New Zealand was half the price of ground beef from Canada. If you're from New Zealand, tell me, please, how does that work? How does shipping ground beef from the furthest point on the planet from where I am right here, how is that economically viable? And how does it end up being half the price of Canadian beef? I don't get it. Anyway, so I pivoted to the ground beef and then I decided to sort of switch up the recipe completely and make it as a casserole instead of the chicken and grits that we made in the last video. So I'm flying without a net. I've got a bunch of stuff out here. Some of it was just in the fridge, and I want to use it up, and I'm going to put it in the recipe, and we're going to see what happens. This is how I encourage you to cook. Don't get too set on a recipe. Don't get sort of, you know, entrenched in something that you can't change. Just have to roll with it. So in this pot, I'm going to make the grits. These are hominy grits, white hominy grits. So into the pot go the hominy grits, a little bit of salt, some water, and a couple cups of milk. Any kind of grits, any kind of ground corn, any kind of polenta, any of that would work. And as I was making this up in the kitchen, getting all the mise en place ready in the kitchen, kind of occurred to me that you could use that cornmeal muffin mix. I've never used it, but I know that it's big in the United States. I know a lot of people do use it. Just do that. Put that as the base layer, and then put the this sort of concoction that I'm going to make on top of it, and then bake it. Just like those sauce and cakes, you know, where the cake bakes at the bottom, and then you've got that sauce on top. Whereas the sauce on the bottom and the cake is on top. Anyway, okay, so cook your polenta, grits, whatever you're making there, cornmeal, as per the package directions. And in this pot, in goes the ground beef. And we're just gonna brown that. Okay, the ground beef is browning nicely. To that, I'm gonna add some of our homemade taco seasoning, taco spice. Mix that in. Mushrooms. So I had mushrooms left over in the fridge from pizza night. They were at that point where they needed to be used, so I'm throwing them in. I like mushrooms. I like mushrooms with beef. They give a really great flavor, but you know, totally optional. Totally optional. Don't fret about it. You don't like mushrooms, don't try to think up some sort of substitution for them. Just leave them out. Totally leave them out. Okay, so I'm gonna keep moving on with some of the veg. 1.5 onions, because I had half onion in a container in the fridge. Use 2 onions, use 1 onion. How big is an onion anyway? I had a couple of stalks of celery, same sort of deal. They were in the fridge, they needed to go. In they go. This is a hot banana pepper left over from pizza night. Half a red bell pepper and half a green bell pepper. The other half of the red and green bell pepper are in Julie's lunch for the rest of the week. So in those go. A little bit of salt. Salt to taste. Okay, so I'm just going to stir this up and cook it off. I'm going to scrape up that browning that's on the bottom as the peppers and the onions give off some of their liquid. And scrape that up. And I just want to cook this until the onions and the mushrooms have broken down a bit. this is coming along nicely. I'm just going to turn the heat down a little bit on that one. The grits are looking pretty good too. Now, for the grits, I'm going to put in cheese and some pickled jalapeno peppers. I'm going to put the jalapenos in now and just let that continue to bubble away a little bit. There we go for that. Into this mixture, a couple of cans of Rotel tomatoes. If you live outside of Canada and the United States, Rotel is finely chopped tomatoes and green chilies in a can. I really like the flavor. Any canned tomato would work. And these are canned chopped green chilies or hatch chilies. I'm gonna put those in as well. Okay, so I'm gonna stir that in. Now, this definitely takes this into sort of a pseudo Tex-Mex type flavor deal. But you could take this into an Italian-American flavor profile. Make this as a yellow polenta, yellow cornmeal polenta as the base layer, and then take this flavoring into more of an Italian-American type flavoring with garlic and all of those other spices. You could make this into almost any flavor combination that works for you, something that you really like. And I encourage you to take it there. This is just but one way to make this sort of thing. I don't even know what to call this, although I'm sure there's a name. I can't imagine that I've come up with this. There's a name. And it's sort of like way back on the old cookbook show, we did a recipe from the 1930s from St. Catharines, Ontario, which is just, you know, not far from here. And it was it a tamale pie where there was like a ground beef layer and then a cornmeal layer on top? I'm just flipping them and making flavors that work for me. I'm gonna say these grits are done for as far as I wanna take them now. I'm gonna add in, this is some freshly grated sharp old cheddar. So I'm gonna mix that into the grits. Get that into our casserole dish. A nice layer. And then the meat and veg layer on top. Ooh. A layer of cheese on top of that. So I've got the oven preheated to 350 degrees Fahrenheit. About a half an hour until Julie gets home from work. And then I'll pull it out when she gets home. And it'll probably sit on the counter for 15 or 20 minutes while she fusses and gets ready for supper. And then we'll serve it.
Hey, Glen.
Hey, Jules.
Hey, friends. Oh. I can smell that outside. That's like I can smell the tomato-y kind of, you know.
That's good. Maybe it's a win.
Maybe you're not sure?
Well, I just kind of made it up.
So you reach into the spoon thing and you get the worst spoon sometimes. What have you got in here?
I should have cooked the meat sauce down a little more, driven off a little bit more moisture than I did. But I don't think that's a huge deal.
No, I feel it's one of those things that, you know, version. Okay, what have we got in here? What is the?
So it's cheesy hominy grits with chopped up pickled jalapenos in it.
Mm-hmm.
And then sort of meat sauce on top. Some would call it, it's almost chili. It's like a kind of a chili type thing.
But it
thing.
Feels like an inverted.
Yes.
Shepherd's pie, cottage pie kind of style.
Tamale pie.
Yeah, inverted tamale pie?
Yeah.
There you go. Named.
It's got a lot of the flavors that I really like.
Yeah. That's really good.
Finished up the mushrooms that were in the bottom of the crisper.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah,
we had a few of those left over. You know? That's really good. I like that. That's gonna be a requested again, I think.
Yeah. Now, like I said earlier, I know we've got viewers in New Zealand. Can you tell me how you're exporting ground beef to Canada cheaper than I can buy Canadian beef?
All right. So all our economics professor friends down there in, or cattlemen.
Yep.
Cattle, that's not the right word, but.
I knew you had sheep. I didn't know that you had a huge extensive cattle operation. Anyway, let us know. This is kind of a winner. And play with it. I mean.
I'd put more beans in.
Beans?
Oh, do you even have a beans?
No, there's no beans
there
in
it. There you
go. But no beans would be really good, and beans would extend your meat. If you're trying to, you know, watch your budget, beans would extend the meat. And
or you're vegetarian.
Yeah, and just play with the flavorings. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.
That's going to go well.
Mm-hmm.
Really good.
So if you've made it this far in the video, thank you. I know that a lot of people make it to the very end of our videos, which is amazing to me. Something like 25% of you viewers make it to the very end, which is uncommon for YouTube.
I'm still eating.
Which means you enjoy our videos, and I thank you very much. If you'd like to help support the channel, because it's free for you to watch, but it costs us real money to make this. Consider subscribing, liking, sharing. Those are the really easy things to do. You can join the channel, you could buy us a coffee, or you could get yourself one of these really nice aprons. Links below to that. And I thank you so much for making it all the way to the end. See you soon.